Hi everyone, welcome to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. On this channel, we mostly review and test fitness wearables. In order to test continuous SpO2 on smartwatches, we need a particularly accurate and medically certified device. And we have that in front of us today, the Wellue O2 Ring Wearable Sleep Monitor. The O2 Ring takes a heart rate and SpO2 reading every 1 second. If you're new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way. In essence, the O2 Ring is a medical grade continuous ring oxygen monitor. The ring in the name does suggest that you place it on your finger, but not only does it show you the spot and continuous pulse rate and SpO2 metrics on the OLED touchscreen, it also alerts you via vibrations that are adjustable in strength if it records low oxygen level or abnormal heart rate. In addition, there is a free iOS and Android app that records and plots your latest results onto SpO2 and heart rate charts. You can analyze your trends, export the data, and so forth. There is a lot to show and tell about this minimalistic device. Hence, without further ado, let's get into it. We'll start off with unboxing the ring, we'll cover the design and ergonomics of the O2 ring, and then we'll get into the features and functions. We'll also show you how to use the ring, how to get the maximum benefit from the app, and how to export data to other devices, even your PC. The packaging is neat and quite simple. Slide off the outer sleeve and a white unmarked box is revealed. Open the lid by tugging on the black string. You are met with a warranty card, a fold-out user guide, and manual. On the side there is a micro USB cable for charging the ring, and here is the actual ring. Let's pull it out. Considering the size, you really don't expect it to weigh just 15 grams. Let's charge the ring by connecting the USB charger. Charging till full usually takes 2 to 3 hours. A full battery will usually last you 12 to 16 hours. I can squeeze in 2 nights of sleep before recharging. Once the ring is charged and you put it on, it switches on automatically. There's a light vibration and the OLED screen lights up with 2 values being shown, your pulse rate, or in essence the heart rate, and the SpO2 or oxygen saturation in your blood. The ring is a one-size-fits-all. Dimensions are 1.5 inch by 1.2 inch. The outer OLED touchscreen is black and slick. You get to see key health stats and the battery charge left. The inner ring is made of soft silicone that wraps around your finger for a relatively tight fit to keep the device in place and stop it spinning around. The ring circumference is rubberized and stretches from 50 to 82 millimeters. If we look inside the ring, we will see the LED emitter and the photodiode on the other side. What these 2 points indicate is that the O2 ring implements transmissive pulse oximetry technology. Let's discuss how the pulse oximeter works and what it actually measures. An oximeter uses LEDs emitting both red and infrared light. A photodetector is positioned on the other side of the finger, opposite the LEDs, and detects the amount of light, whether it is red or infrared light, passing through the measurement site. The amount of light absorbed depends on how much oxygen the hemoglobin in your blood is carrying. Let's pretend these red shapes are hemoglobin. And as we all know, hemoglobin is a package of red blood cells, and it has a key function of transporting oxygen to the body tissues. The test relies on the fact that oxygenated and deoxygenated hemoglobin absorb different wavelengths of light. The oximeter then displays your SpO2 level. The values range from 35 to 99%. Generally, a value over 93% is satisfactory. Now that we know how and what the O2 ring measures, let's get into the features and functions offered by the O2 ring. As mentioned earlier, it is a plug-and-play device. As long as the device has some charge, you can use it straight away. By watching the OLED display, you can simply see the spot readings, but by installing the VHealth app from the Apple Store or Google Play Store, you get to see continuous readings that were plotted in trends. The plots can be zoomed into and most importantly exported either as images or in detailed CSV tabular form, where every SpO2 and heart rate reading is recorded every 4 seconds. Now, the key takeaway here is that even if the app exports data with a 4-second interval, while the actual measured interval is once per second. So within the hour, you will have 3,600 readings. You can hardly get more granularity than that. The oxygen level range is 70 to 99% and the pulse rate range is 30 to 250 beats per minute. Let's take a look at the app. Once you've installed it, simply switch on your Bluetooth and then tap the O2 ring circle icon to wake it up, and you'll see your ring as a connected device, alongside any other Bluetooth Viatom device you own. In the app, there are four available screens. Let's start off with the settings screen, where we can customize and adjust the ring to our preferences. The O2 ring can be used at any time during the day or night, but I mostly use it for nighttime, as this is the time when I can pick up signs of hypoxia, sleep apnea, and measure the resting heart rate, which is a key input for heart rate variability measures and general state of the nervous system, aka ANS. For more detail into these topics, take a look into our heart rate playlist. I'm a deep sleeper, hence I set my vibration intensity to strong. The vibration alert is very useful, waking me up if my vitals drop below a certain SpO2 level, and the vibration will prompt me to wake up and shift sleeping positions. You can also adjust the reminders, but I keep them to their default values as they're simply informative in nature and bring the reminders to the dashboard. Just below you have the device settings. Adjusting screen brightness to low or medium will prolong some battery life as opposed to using them in the high setting. Let's jump to the dashboard screen. This is your spot or at a point in time screen, where you can see what your SpO2 and pulse rate values are at this very moment of wearing the O2 ring. Now let's go to the history screen. It has a list of all your sessions. You can see the plots and trends of your SpO2, pulse rate and motion once you tap into a particular session. Above the plots, you will notice the summary screen of your particular session. The key takeaways here are the recording time, the time where the SpO2 fell below 90%. Also note the average and lowest SpO2 levels. Viatom have included a very handy gauge called O2 score, which is essentially a measure of oxygen shortage during the whole sleep. The metric includes and combines frequency, duration, and depth of oxygen level drops during your sleep. The higher the score, the more oxygen is available. So the greener, the better, and generally a value of 8 or over will keep you in the green zone. Now it's time to touch upon data exporting for analysis or to transfer it to your medical advisor. Click the share button in the top right corner of the history screen. We get three options to share, either as a picture, a binary file, or CSV. I prefer the CSV format as it presents the data in tabular form in 4-second intervals that I can use to plot and compare the reading in detail to the sport and smartwatches that we test and review on the WesKnows channel. Another point to mention is hygiene. Usually after my sleep, I take an antibacterial wipe and wipe inside and outside of the ring. After all, you did wear it all night long. The ring is IP24, so it should be okay if you're using a damp cloth on it. Thanks for watching the review. If you did find it useful and insightful, then please click on the red subscribe button below the video to ensure you don't miss any of the upcoming content.